All right. So last time that we played, y'all left the library. You met an interesting wizard there who invited y'all to come back to his tower, which had the name Araj. And basically, after researching, y'all found out that the reason why the demon lords were loose is because somebody attempted to summon one of them or something like that, and his spell went horribly wrong, and they ended up getting loose in the Underdark.
Or at least that particular one.
Yep. What's that?
Nothing. I was just saying that each one has happened to make their way through in their own way.
And after y'all kind of collaborated, each of you had some different visions that kind of gave some backstory as to why the different demon lords are here, what they're kind of up to. He invited y'all back to his tower to kind of compare notes, and overall, because he has an idea of how to get the demon lords the hell out of the Underdark and back to, I guess you would say, out of the abyss, if you would, or maybe back into the abyss.
Them back to Jersey.
Yep, back to Jersey. I'm going back to Cali. 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 The adventure, or the journey to the tower, was rather uneventful, I believe.
Pretty much.
And upon arriving there, and him muttering his words into some secret doors that opened up, and as you make your way closer to the tower, you get a better look at, and this is kind of what you see.
Quite nice.
So this guy invited us back for Netflix and chill. That's
Yeah.
why.
Yes, he wants to Netflix and chill with all of y'all. You do notice a slight aroma of seduction in the air.
Mildewy potpourri.
Yeah.
Is it potpourri or poopery?
It depends on your smelling, I guess. It could either be potpourri or poopery. So as you approach, the outside around the tower is dark, obviously. But as you approach and go up into the tower, there seem to be globes of light kind of dancing around, that is kind of creating like an ambience of light. As y'all approach, he mutters some more words, and y'all kind of step into the tower, and you feel as if something would have been holding you back, but he muttered some words that kind of let you pass through like a shield of sort.
A barrier, if you will.
Yep, a kind of like a barrier.
Can I do an arcana check as I walk through?
Yep, absolutely. How are you doing tonight, Miss Eggy? Hope you're doing good. Hope you are ready for tomorrow night. Right, so
Pretty good.
what exactly were you checking?
Just wanted to see if I could either identify the level of the spell or if it was just like a basic barrier spell to ward off evil or something.
You get the feeling that the warding spells that he has around this tower are far beyond your skill level. That if you were to try to counter it or dispel it or something like that, it would probably end up with you maybe disintegrating at best, or some other things at worse.
Okay.
So he didn't get these at Walmart. He actually went to a good warding store.
Yes, he did.
He may come at Kmart. They're on the closeout special.
he went to Whole Foods and got this spell. He didn't go to Walmart. So as you go up into the tower, you notice that there appears to be like a shaft running up the center of the tower that is kind of levitating. It almost kind of like an elevator of sorts.
Interesting. What's this elevator you speak of?
I am thoroughly impressed.
Yeah, he got I can't think of the name of the elevator company here in town.
Well, they're in the Underdark. I think they're exclusively Otis, aren't they?
Yes. Yeah, probably so. All right, so y'all kind of make your way in. You all wander into the shaft with him. He mutters the word Kalam, and as you do so, you all slowly begin to kind of rise up the center of this tower. At last, you finally stop, and you come out on. The fourth floor, which is kind of like his laboratory. So he invites y'all in. You kind of settle down, and some servants that look well, apparently they are staying true to their names of unseen servants, because I can't find a picture of them.
Oh, that's because they're completely invisible.
There you go.
Yeah.
I figure they would have some kind of stats or something, but apparently not.
No, the unseen servant is based on a spell that the most they can carry is like 30 pounds.
Okay. Well, these servants you suspect begin bringing in trays of mushrooms, meat, drink, and stuff like that. And he also passes drink around to y'all, and as well, he takes some. He makes a point for y'all to see him drink first, and then he kind of looks to y'all to see if y'all drink as well.
Sure. And grab some of them shrooms, too, so I can hallucinate a little bit.
Here you go. Ale and shrooms.
Uso will take a drink.
All right.
And a mushroom.
I won't take a drink until I feel he's been thoroughly offended.
Okay. All right. He can kind of respect that. So after a drink, he begins to kind of go over everything. The only one of my kind who could ever match me in the arts of Gromp Bainry. I think we knew from the moment we met there that we were destined to be rivals. But where I sought only to master the art, Gromp was also an astute political manipulator. No more devout than I in the service of the Spider Queen. He arranged for my disgrace and exile. Deprived of my considerable skills, my house fell to our rival, House de Orden. Gromf became the Archmage of Menzo Baron Zan under the auspices of his own house, first house of the ruling council. Gromf and I only ever had two things in common. our passion for the art, and our hatred of the manner in which our fellow mages suffer at the hands of the matron mothers and mistress of the drow. Grumph has always hungered for power, and not even becoming archmage of Menzo Baranzan was enough to satisfy him. Am I saying that right?
Yes.
Nice.
Good enough.
Good enough.
Yeah, close enough.
From this tower of exile, I kept watch on Gromp's activities. This was no easy task, given his suspicious and circumspect nature. Nonetheless, my observations revealed that he was crafting a unique ritual, one that somehow drew on the energy of the Phaserness to channel incalculable arcane power. When Gromp performed this ritual, the walls between the planes shuddered. Then, as you have by now realized, the demon lords were wrenched from their layers of the abyss and cast about here in the Underdark. What we all witness in Graven Hollow confirms this.
Hey Chris, real quick, what's this guy's name again? I meant to write it down and I never did.
Bezran, Bizeran. Devir, Devir.
Okay.
He's in the combat tracker, right? Bizeran?
Yeah, he is.
Yeah.
And you're right, it is Phaserness, but it's one of those damn tongue-twisting words.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, what they said.
What they said.
I've been doing a lot of that recently in some chats where it's just like up arrow because it's like literally exactly what I just said. So what are we doing?
So he goes on to explain to y'all that Loth is behind the plot to bring the Demon Lords to the Underdark through her manipulation of Gromph Bainry. The Spider Queen is using the drow as pawns in her schemes to dispose of her demonic rivals and seize power in the abyss.
Makes sense.
The demon lords of the abyss, along with many of their lesser servants and legions, have been set loose in the Underdark after Gromp's ritual. And unfortunately, the presence of the demon lords is warping the fabric of the Underdark. The Phaserness that permeates has kind of acting like a conduit. So the maddening effect that the Demon Lords is having is almost kind of like flowing through this throughout the Underdark. Upon research, Gromph has vanished after this ritual. He is nowhere to be found, and Bizrin has been unable to locate him.
So he's either gone into hiding or Loth has hidden him away.
Yeah, it seems kind of funny too, because the whole matriarchal setup of the Underdark and the drow, that she would use a male wizard to pull this shit off.
Maybe that's the only reason he was able to get away with it, because he was not looked at as closely.
Maybe she's just horny.
I think she just used him as a pawn.
Because
well,
she was horny.
We did see plenty of hatchlings whenever we saw a vision of her, if I recall.
So he goes on to explain that Demogorgon, the prince of the demons, arrived in the Claw Rift of Benzo Baron Zan and begin to rampage through the city before he ended up escaping further into the Underdark. That he has, through all his research, he